Continuing the series of advanced blockchain tools, today you will see a set of tools for working with ewasm, Ethereum-flavored WebAssembly. ewasm, JSVM, an ewasm VM for the web, and an associated ewasm debugger. And the actors for today are a YUL contract, SOLC for compiling YUL to ewasm, a disassembler, wasm to WebAssembly text, an ewasm executor with in-browser JavaScript and WebAssembly, the ewasm.js VM project, and a React component to show changes at each step for the above, using debugging information from ewasm.js VM. And all of these components are coming together on the main stage, Factotum. Factotum is a modern web IDE that I will present in depth in a future video. This is the YUL contract, which calls several opcode functions, stores a value, and emits several logs. With SOLC, I compiled this code to ewasm bytecode, and here I have the contract's interface description. One function named main, with two inputs and several outputs. I loaded the ewasm.js VM package in Factotum, so here we can deploy the bytecode from C5 and get the runtime bytecode. Now we can take this runtime bytecode from B11 and we can plug it in the WAPT module and transform it into WebAssembly text. And we can see all of the VM function that this module, which is an ewasm contract, expects to receive in the import object given at instantiation, so it can be ran. And here, deploying the contract and running the main function with these arguments. And this is the output. But the ewasm.js VM package lets us peek under the hood of what's happening, and we can retrieve the intermediate states and build a debugger. So Factotum has the eth2 debugger function, which receives the wasm bytecode from C5, the ABI from C4, and the function arguments. And we can run it. This is the ewasm debugger alpha version. And we can see all the opcode functions from the constructor, and then the runtime code, and the chain state that has been touched by the script. Empty memory slots have been hidden, so we can clearly see what changes after executing each opcode. And we have access at the input and output values for each opcode function. And we can see each log that was emitted by the script. And the storage map. And finally, we can see the script's encoded output and the final decoded result. We are building these tools for Taylor, because in the long term, Taylor will be able to bridge EVM1 to Ethereum2. And as future demos, look forward to seeing how the ewasm player can be transformed into a powerful debugger for ewasm and even EVM1 with the help of our EVM1 interpreter and EVM1-based Taylor language. And how the EVM1 interpreter can be used as a prover for optimistic rollups and L2 scaling. Also, I will go in depth about how Factotum may be the most flexible IDE for Solidity, YUL, and ewasm.